Hi, my name is Nico Neufeld from the European Organization for Nuclear Research, better known as CERN, in Geneva, Switzerland. In this presentation, I'm going to show you how we use high-performance computing to process live data produced at the Large Hadron Collider. You will have heard about the Large Hadron Collider, which is the largest particle accelerator in the world. It's situated at the border between Switzerland and France. It's about 100 meters underground and 27 kilometers in circumference. It hosts four large detectors in which we bring protons to collision, and protons collide every 25 nanoseconds. Specifically, I'm going to tell you about one of these experiments, which is called the LHC-B, the B stands for beauty experiment. The LHC-B experiment is a large detector, as you can see indicated on this sketch here. Consists of many subcomponents, and all the subcomponents host in total several million individual detector channels. Each detector channel needs to be read out for every individual collision. So every 25 nanoseconds, we have to read the data from all these millions of channels. For this, we have built what can be rightly called a high-performance computing system, which is have an emphasis on high data throughput. You can see this here. You have In the top part, you see these detector front end electronics, which is essentially custom built electronics to process the analog data, which is then digitized and pushed over more than 11,000 optical links into a farm of high performance servers, which I will discuss in the following. These servers, each of them contains now a fraction of these optical links and hence a geographical piece of the detector. So these fibers are connected directly to certain locations of the detector. Now, in order to do processing, you need to bring all the pieces of the detector into a single location. And for this, we do an all-to-all exchange between these servers so that you bring fragments from each location in alternating turns into one of these servers. And for this purpose, we have connected the service with an HDR InfiniBand network. Once this is done, the data is fed through GPGPUs for a first level of processing where data is analyzed and then various collisions are selected and others are discarded. And the remaining data is then stored for subsequent processing on a large online storage. So the take home messages here are that the numbers are quite impressive. We have more than 12,000 links. Each link brings us about 4 gigabit per second. It means if you subtract headers and reduce some duplication, you have more than 40 terabits of data to treat every second. So these data are distributed over the 170 servers, which I have described before. And the filtering is done in approximately 500 GPUs, which are distributed over these servers. Each server for this purpose has to hold 3 FPGA cards, which receive the proprietary optical links. It has 2 HDR interfaces for the exchange of the data between the servers, and it can host up to 3 GPUs. This means that there's an enormous amount of I/O in each of these servers, and only a very powerful IO-powerful server allows you to build a compact system for so much data with so few servers. And for this, we have found the AMD Arrow EPIC servers to be uniquely well suited. We use specifically a platform by Gigabyte, which exposes all the available PCI Express lanes for use in double width slots, which is convenient for our GPU cards and for our FPGA cards. We have done some tests on these servers and we were very impressed to find that even if you populate them with 8 HDR cards, each running at full duplex speed, we cannot bring the platform to its knees, which is truly, truly remarkable. You can see a plot here from some of the tests we did. So building this platform, we can now get the data in, process the data, do the data exchange, process the data again, and send the remaining data out. That is clearly possible only because of the Gen 4 capability on the EPIC platform. So I'm very much looking forward to the next generation of AMD's platform and to further tests on AMD GPUs. Thank you.